It's a game for the uninhibited. Our stars this week, Vicki Lawrence and Jamie Farr. Watch their bodies do the talking on Body Language. And here's the star of Body Language, Tom Kennedy.
Hey. Give me another chance. Hello there. Welcome, America. Thank you. Thank you. You're very kind. You know how to make a guy feel good. Welcome to Body Language, a game for the uninhibited. Let's meet our players. Vicki Lawrence, ladies and gentlemen, from Mama's Family. And let me see if I get it right. On the cable network, we have a show called the American Homemaker.
That's right. The Great American Homemaker.
The Great American Homemaker.
Why does that...
5 days.
It's hard for him to look at me and say Great American Homemaker for some reason.
I don't know why that is.
I am.
I'm sure you are.
It's typecasting for me.
Of course it is. Are you enjoying the show?
This one or that one?
Either.
Both.
Both of them. Well, that's great news. We haven't met this lady yet. What's your last name, Wendy?
Gill.
Wendy Gill, tell us about yourself.
Well, I'm a student at Cal State Long Beach. I just received my bachelor's degree in business marketing.
Oh, good.
I grew up in Palm Springs, California, and this summer I plan on going to Greece, and I know I'm going to have a great time.
Well, good.
Poor
tough
thing.
Life, isn't it?
Bless her heart.
Oh, that's beautiful.
She's an underprivileged child.
It's good that you go
child.
These rough times, because when you start making it big, then you can appreciate it. Anyway, welcome to you,
thank
Wendy.
You.
Welcome to you, Mr.
Thank you,
Farr.
Mr. Kennedy.
Fine actor.
Thank you. Up until now, yes. You know, this body language between the staple gun I did one of these days and the affirming, my body language says black and blue.
Yeah.
Yes, I'm in
he
just
has bettered
misery.
His body tremendously. It
yes.
is a very physical show, but you're doing a very good job.
Well, I hit my nose and the swelling hasn't gone down. It's terrible. I don't know what...
Jamie's partner, go ahead.
Eugene Rabenzer. See, I remember from the other day.
Eugene...
I could just get the puzzle.
Is our current champ, and he has $8,700. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Still going, good.
Oh, yeah, good.
All right. Got a little chilly in here, so he put a sweater on. That's terrific. Now, the object of body language is to act out a series of words to help you solve a puzzle. That's the way we do it. Vicki, would you get out there into starting position, please? And Wendy, you get on over here. What did she just say to you? What did she say?
Come on out here, Wendy.
Oh, she said, come on out here, Wendy?
Good luck. I said, here we go. Is that okay?
I
she was
said.
A little nervous. And I said, well, you don't have long to wait because we go first. So here we go. Is
that's
that okay?
It's fine with me, Vicki. Whatever you want.
I was trying to make her feel at home.
Well, what do you want to
good job.
Now that you're here, what do you want to do?
Well,
want me to show
you're
going to
give
words?
Me a series of five words that are going to fit into a puzzle that I'll see
wait a minute,
little bit
fit
later.
Into a what?
They're going to fit into a puzzle that I'll get to see a little bit later.
Oh, I see.
And the more words that I can convey to her in 60 seconds, the better chance she'll have at getting that puzzle, which will appear right over here.
I see. Oh, uh-huh,
see, and you'll fill up with those five words, and then she'll get to guess what that is.
Oh, good.
So, and if I decide to pass a word...
Yeah. What happens then?
I can do that. I can do that.
You can?
Yeah. Then we can come back to that word if time permits.
Oh.
See, so now if we could just have 60 seconds on the clock, you'll get the hell out of here.
Come on, Tom, you get in here. You go ahead and get to it.
Just... You know, that's frightening. She did better than I do.
Found out we didn't need you.
That's right. Can we have 60 seconds on the clock? Here's your first word. Go.
You're choking. You're hot. You're getting a drink of water. You're thirsty.
Yes, next word.
You're sitting on a horse. You're riding a camel.
Yes, next word.
Up in the sky, it's the sun. It's
yes, next word.
You're angry. You're mad. You're vicious. You're evil. You're ferocious. You're a villain. You're a bad person. Oh, you're sweet. You're
pass, next word.
You're picking something up. It's round. You're touching. It's hot. You're burning yourself. Oh, match. A fire. A log. A hot log. Ooh, a blister. Your finger is hot. What happened?
Pass. Next word. Repeating.
You're angry. You're so mean. You're vicious. You're bad. You're evil. You're ferocious. You're making bad faces at me.
You have 10 seconds.
You're epic.
Pass. Next word.
Picking something up. It's hot, flames, coal, fire, matches, smells nice. Looks good. It's
hot. Time is up. What else? That's good.
Best camel I've ever seen.
You got 3 words, 3 out of 5. We're going to show you now that puzzle that she said you were going to see. Here are now the 3 words you have earned. Let's look at the words here. Camel is one, and another is thirsty, and another is sun. Now, let's read the puzzle. If you're a camel or a blank, this is the blank for you. But not if you're thirsty and blank, sun and blank. For $100. She thinks she knows, don't you?
Is it the desert?
Is it the desert? For $100, you got it. That's the way you play the game. Now you're going to learn what she was trying to transmit with those leers and jeers and sneers. Could we see the rest of the puzzle, as a matter of fact? Number 2, if you're a camel or a cactus, that's the thing that you said was pretty, and she got stuck with it. This is the place for you, but not if you're thirsty and hate. Hatred was coming out of every pore of your body. Hate, sun, and sand. You got $100, and the first team to reach $500 wins the game and a chance to shoot for $10,000. Jamie Farr's team up next after this.